everybody, and welcome to another episode of Nick and Knarf. So glad you could join us today. How you doing?
Good to see you.
This is Nick. Hey. I'm Knarf.
There we go.
There's two of us here, so that makes us Nick and Knarf. So
two brothers from Tucson playing the music of the 60s, 70s, 80s, and beyond.
Oh, yes, and we go beyond and before and through and under and over everything for your ears, because we care for your ears and we love you. And today we're doing another one in our series of wonderful stuff called Double Dan Day. This is our fifth one already. Nicky, why don't you move over here, my brother? Because you got the album cutting your face out.
Oh, that's okay. The album's better looking.
Oh, no, he's not. You're way better. Anyway, today we got two great selections.
Steely Dan, guys.
Yeah, you know, we've gotten four of these, and you guys love our Steely Dan shows, and we are so honored to bring them for you because we care for your ears. We love you guys, and we want to remind you before we start, please, if you haven't, subscribe, like, and share with your friends. Let them know about Nick and Knarf. We've got, like, now 50 videos, so we've got a pretty great catalog of music for you to tell your friends about and to share if you haven't seen them all. Hope you'll check them out.
And we do love your guys' comments. You guys are so knowledgeable. You guys have such a wide variety of taste that you love. You've educated me a lot. I don't know about Frank, but you've educated me
a lot smarter
on
too.
So many musical notes, side notes, bands. We're listening to different acts that you sent our way, so it's kind of cool.
Absolutely. We appreciate your love and support, and we thank you for being here. Anyway, we got two great choices for you today for Double Dan Day 5. I selected off of the Pretzel Logic album the jumpy, infectious song Barrytown, which is one of my favorites on the album. And Nick picked another great one, which, God, I love this one too. I would have picked it myself. Maybe I hadn't picked Barrytown, but it's off of the Royalscam. It's Caves of Altamira.
Yeah, and Barrytown, obviously, is where right near Bard College, where both Fagen and Becker attended. So when we were thinking Barrytown, always reminds me of Pennsylvania. I think Pennsylvania, but these guys are from New York, so what do I know? Anyway, it's pretty simple, direct. It's kind of just an observation of life.
It's just an infectious song with an incredible, it's one of Steely Dan's perhaps more mainstream poppy kind of tunes, but it's just got such a driving melody and you get caught up in it. But anyway, from Pretzel Logic, which is the third studio album released in 1974, it's Steely Dan and Barrytown. Let's get into it. Here we go.
Slide guitar is nice.
Just like the other.
you don't talk.
They won't act as kindly if they see you on the street. And don't you scream or make a shout. It's nothing you can do about. It was there when you came out. It's a special lack of grace. I can see it in your face. I can see by the
obviously, the first thing that comes to mind when you hear that song is the way Fagen is singing it. I see what you care. I mean, you know, he's got that kind of an almost wind tunnel sound.
I know. You know, he sounds really animated in this song. You know, it's one of the, you know, Donald Sagan always sounds like, kind of, he's like, he's Mr. Cool and Smooth. This is one where he kind of amped up his energy level to sing the song. And it's kind of funny because you realize how sarcastic and snarky the song kind of is. But we found out that Barrytown is right near Annandale.
Yeah.
It's not far from Annandale where they went to Bard College. So
my old school.
Obviously, it's somebody they met who was from a little town nearby, and this song came out of it. But what did you think of Barrytown? I love this song. It is just jumpy, infectious, and just so catchy. Just so catchy.
It really is. And I'm with you. That hook when they go in the beginning, it's so nice.
Absolutely.
Very nice. Doesn't skip a beat. Just nice. The layers are great. Obviously, no great crazy lead guitar in this song, but that's okay, you know, especially because the first three songs on the album, by the way, are just sickly, you know.
Absolutely, every album's good. Anyway, tell us what you thought about Barrytown. Please leave some comments, subscribe, like, share. We're caring for your ears again with Steely Dan, and we're coming back after the intermission because we got to change the CD. We're going to be playing Nick's selection from the Royalscam, Caves of
Altamira.
Thanks
for putting up with our clowning around, but that is kind of just a goofball song, and we kind of like it.
It is fun.
I like it a lot.
Okay, we'll be right back in a second.
So welcome back, everybody, to Double Dan Day number 5. We just had a quick intermission so we could change the CDs, and we're going to be coming now with Caves of Altamira. Love this song. This is from the album...
Royalscam.
This is the first three songs of their album that I think are probably their best three. I almost confused it with our... before we went to the break, but...
Yeah, we
Charlemagne,
talked about it.
Case of Altamira, and then
Don't Take Me Alive,
which we've played before. But Caves of Altamira, a great song, just about in Spain. There are those caves in Altamira where it shows the animals on there, and they're actually in color.
They use pigments and stuff, the Neanderthals that went into the deep into the caves and painted there. And I guess we saw that in an interview with Donald Fagen and Walter Becker in the early 2000s that they were both trying to give their take on what it was about. And Walter Becker had this kind of cryptic response, but Donald Fagen had this more matter of fact. But so it's about a guy who goes to see the caves of Altamira and he's amazed by it. It's kind of like, okay, well, we kind of figured that out. But but it's just such an amazing song with the clever lyrics, you know, such unique lyrics and the great horns in that song.
And, this song actually reminds me of when my son was growing up and we'd, you know, read dinosaur books that he was probably just so enthralled with the dinosaurs when he first heard about the caves of Altamira that he was thinking about cavemen, et cetera. And to write a song about it, I think is so creative. I mean, it's, tells me the imagination
clever.
That
just
these
so clever
have.
And it's I wonder if they actually went to see the cave, if Donald Fagen and them did go there to Spain to see them.
When
I
you got
probably
that kind
do.
Of money, you might as well.
Oh yeah, what a place to go. Anyway, from the fifth studio album from Steely Dan, the Royalscam in 1976, it's Caves of Altamira. Let's give her a listen. We'll be right back.
a flashlight.
On the stone, an ancient hand in a faded yellow green made alive a worldly wonder often told but never seen. Now and never bound to labor on the sea and in the sky.
So many nice things about this song. It reminds me of the big band era, watching some 50s. But I also love the kind of like half tempo between some of the breaks, you know? I love that.
What dawned on me on that song, and I really re-listening to it for the first time in a while, how horn driven it is.
It really
man,
is.
Oh man, there's almost no guitar work. I was listening to it. The outro is all horns. It's sax and trumpets.
Yeah.
And then the majority of the song is piano, bass, trumpet, a little bit of background guitar, but mostly horn driven. And it really has this kind of spectacular quality to it because it really kind of accents the piano pace, you know, with the horns, and then the imaginative lyrics about imagining yourself being a kid who would wander, like maybe a Neanderthal kid who found the cave and would go in there with a candle and paint an image on the wall and then moving it forward into the world. Then the kind of insight, that lovely little line, it's such a kind of an imaginative poetic line about before there was any Hollywood, like picking Hollywood is kind of the embodiment of the modern version of those caves where artists would go to put their images and their memories and their thoughts to project, to leave it. The way Hollywood now makes movies to record stuff to keep for mankind.
And I think your point is so well taken. Both of these songs that we have literally any guitar at all in them. And it just tells us about the evolution of Steely Dan. What got us in the beginning, no doubt about it, for me, was, I mean, of course, the sax and the horns and some of their songs like My Old School, but their guitar work was just impeccable. So good. Now the refinement, they bring in different drummers. They get the saxophone players that are just like, got to be the best in Hollywood, speaking of Hollywood. But just beautiful. And I mean, again, the jazziness, big band sound almost to it. I'm loving it, man. I just love the progression.
It's a great, great song. Both of the songs are catchy. Of course, you know, you've been with us. All Steely Dan is so damn great. We love it to death, and that's why we can never get enough of it. And I know, what did you guys think of Caves of Altamira? It was a great choice by Nick. I love it. Teamed up with Barrytown. I thought it was a nice combo to bring to you today.
It really was. And again, the fact that we heard very little guitar, which blows me away, because what I love is those great leads stick in your mind. And the fact that you guys are, it doesn't matter what
it just shows
do.
How multidimensional Steely Dan's creative power was. They didn't just stick with one kind of train of thought. They started out, like you said, as a rock and roll band with touches of stuff. Then they became more of a jazz horn band with guitar accents. I mean, you just look at the evolution and the creativity over all these albums. They're just miraculous. That's why Steely Dan is in our top five, I think, all time of great bands. Maybe two or three or four.
They're number two for me. Behind the Beatles, they're number two.
They're so awesome. They're so great. And you guys are awesome and great for being with us today. Remember, if you like what you heard, subscribe, like, and share. Send us your comments about what you thought about today's show. We love bringing it to you because we care for your ears.
Till next time, keep on sending us some great comments.
Absolutely. And thanks again for joining us for another day of Double Dan. And we'll be back soon with a lot more great stuff. So thanks for being a part of our journey. Take care.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.